राइट फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू फैक्ट्स एंड फिगर्स। दिस इज 14th वीक। द फर्स्ट वन इज April 7 इज बीइंग सेलिब्रेटेड एज वर्ल्ड हेल्थ डे एंड द थीम इज डिप्रेशन लेट अस टॉक। एंड डिप्रेशन इज द कॉमन मेंटल डिसऑर्डर एंड एज पर वन एस्टिमेट there are more than 300 million people affected by depression and more women are affected by depression than men. And at the same time, please don't forget the global health campaigns of the World Health Organization. I have given here, this is World Health Day, April 7. And if you look at April 25, World Malaria Day, these things don't forget. Uttar Pradesh is in the news because of two reasons, for closing illegal slaughterhouses and at the same time for creating anti-Romeo squads. And here one important point is, at present Uttar Pradesh is the largest exporter of meat in our country. Second point is, annual meat exports from our country are in the range of $4 billion to $5 billion. And now the government says it is closing illegal slaughterhouses. And at the same time, another point, don't forget, Uttar Pradesh recently waived off some of the farm loans up to 1 lakh rupees. They have waived off the farm loans. And at the same time, the state government announced floating off Kisan Rahat Bonds. These things don't forget. Look at the next one. Professor Sunaina Singh, Vice Chancellor of English and Foreign Languages University, Hyderabad, is going to be the next Vice Chancellor of Nalanda University. Nalanda University, it is in the modern form, but if you go back to the history, that is Nalanda Mahavihara, it is a World Heritage Site. And a large Buddhist monastery in the ancient kingdom of Magadha, and it was a center of learning from around 5th century to 12th century. And this Nalanda University in the modern form came up, and for this Sunaina Singh became the Vice Chancellor. And if you look further, UNESCO stated that Nalanda Mahavihara stands out as the ancient university of the Indian subcontinent. Right, look into the next one. New Development Bank, this is a Shanghai based bank, and KV Kamath is the head of this bank. And recently India signed first loan agreement with NDB, basically for improving the roads for upgradation, rehabilitation or reconstruction of 1500 kilometers of district roads. Right, so if someone is talking about New Development Bank, that is headquartered in Shanghai, and AIIB is headquartered in Beijing. And at the same time, please look at the next question. Davik Isaac, an imprisoned Eritrean Swedish journalist. Eritrea, it is in Africa. Please don't forget, Eritrea is in Africa, and the country is blamed for several human rights violations. And an Eritrean Swedish journalist was awarded the prestigious 2017 UNESCO Guillermo Cano World Press Freedom Prize. And this prize was established in 1997 by UNESCO, and cash prize is $25,000, and it is funded by Colombia-based Cano Foundation and Finland-based Helsingin Sanomat Foundation. And as I have already told you, Eritrea is known for suppressing human rights in Africa, and this award is given for the recognition of courage, resistance and commitment to freedom of expression. Look at the next one. Namami Brahmaputra festival was organized in 21 districts of Assam. When I am looking at Brahmaputra, please don't forget world's largest river island, you can say, that is Mazuli. So Mazuli is the world's largest river island. This is situated in Assam. This is situated around Brahmaputra, or you can say surrounded by Brahmaputra. And Brahmaputra, it flows through two states in India, Assam and Arunachal Pradesh. And at the same time, please don't forget, Teesta River is into the news. And Teesta River flows through two states of India, that is Sikkim and West Bengal. Please don't forget, Teesta passes through Sikkim and West Bengal, whereas the Brahmaputra River passes through Arunachal Pradesh and Assam. Please don't forget the names, Erlung Sangpo, the name of the river in China, and Brahmaputra in India, and Jamuna in Bangladesh. Please don't forget, Namami Brahmaputra festival was organized recently in Assam. Udan, Ude Desh Ka Aam Nagrik. This will cover 43 cities initially, and these include 12 airports where limited and irregular flights are being operated at present, along with 31 destinations that are not connected at all. And 5 airlines were selected. And about Udan, Ude Desh Ka Aam Nagrik, first of its kind globally. 3-4 points don't forget. Regional connectivity fund will be created. Center and state's share is 80-20. Selected airline operator must provide at least 50% of the seats with the subsidy. That comes to minimum 9 and maximum of 40 Udan seats on the Udan flights. And here viability gap funding, or VGF, will be provided jointly by the center and the states to the operating airline. Another point is, 1 hour journey costs ₹2,500 up to a distance of 500 kilometers. The merger of 5 associate banks and Bharatiya Mahila Bank took place on 1st April. With this, SBI has now reached into the top league of 50 banks. As per one news report, SBI has entered into within 50, and at present it is standing at around 45th largest bank globally. And the remaining details I have given here. Look at the next one. Malaysian Prime Minister Najib Razak, he visited India and 6 agreements were signed. And Malaysia extended support to India for greater role in the maritime security of Asia-Pacific region. In Asia-Pacific region, this South China Sea is becoming contentious. Under these circumstances, Malaysia's commitment for India's greater role in maritime security of Asia-Pacific region assumed a lot of significance. At the same time, Malaysia stated that it would allow Indian Ayurveda and Siddha practitioners to serve in that country. Please look into this picture. Let us go ahead. Olympic silver medalist PV Sindhu defeated Carolina Marin in straight sets to win first India Open Super Series title. You may have a doubt with regard to Super Series title. There are 2 categories: Super Series title, Super Series Premier title. These 2 categories are authorized by the World Badminton Federation, and these are elite tournaments. Now, Sindhu won the first India Open Super Series title, and overall, this is the second Super Series title for PV Sindhu. Please don't forget, Super Series as well as Premier Super Series titles are authorized by Badminton World Federation. These are elite badminton tournaments. Look into the next one. 136th Assembly of Inter-Parliamentary Union was held in Bangladesh. Theme I have given here: Redressing Inequalities, Delivering on Dignity and Well-being for All. You may have a pertinent doubt, what is the meaning of Inter-Parliamentary Union? Inter-Parliamentary Union is the international organization of parliaments. and it was established in 1889, and basically for peace and cooperation among the peoples and for the firm establishment of representative democracy. What is the meaning of representative democracy? Representative democracy means we are electing members to Lok Sabha, and Lok Sabha members are representing on our behalf in parliament. That is the meaning of representative democracy. Similarly, we are electing MLAs, and MLAs are representing on our behalf in state assemblies. So these are examples of representative democracy. So you learned about International Organization of Parliaments as well as representative democracy. The Prime Minister participated in sesquicentennial celebrations. All of you are familiar with the centennial celebrations. What is this sesquicentennial celebrations? When 150 years are completed, then sesquicentennial celebrations are held. And recently, the Prime Minister participated in the 150 years celebrations of Allahabad High Court. And the country's largest high court is Allahabad High Court, and it was established initially at Agra in 1866. And please don't forget, Delhi High Court recently celebrated 50 years celebrations. Patna High Court celebrated centenary celebrations. Allahabad High Court celebrated sesquicentennial celebrations. These aspects, please don't forget. Renowned Hindustani classical vocalist who is known for Jaipur Gharana, and she is Hindustani vocalist, and at the same time she belongs to Jaipur Gharana. You may have a doubt, what is meant by Gharana? Quite often we talk about Gharana. Gharana is nothing but basically a community of musicians sharing a distinct musical style. So she belongs to Jaipur Gharana, Hindustani vocalist, and at the same time she got Padma Bhushan in 1987 and Padma Vibhushan in 2002. She died at the age of 84. So more than this, please learn what is meant by Gharana. It is the community of musicians sharing a distinctive musical style. Yogi Adityanath led BJP government in Uttar Pradesh announced farm loan waiver. Here, the loans will be waived up to rupees 1 lakh per each farmer, and this amounts to around 31,000 crores of rupees. And government will also settle around rupees 6,000 crores of NPAs of 7 lakh small and marginal farmers. And at the same time, Uttar Pradesh government will go for Kisan Rahat bonds, and marginal farmer, small farmer, difference I have given here, please go through it. Up to 2.5 acres, up to 5 acres, from 2.5 acres, the farmers are categorized as marginal farmer, small farmer. Defense Acquisition Council. You may have a doubt, who heads Defense Acquisition Council? It is headed by the Defense Minister and approved the purchase of Barak surface to air missile for the Indian Navy at a value of rupees 860 crore. And these Barak missiles are the product of Israel. Right? So please don't forget, this Barak missiles are, these are surface to air missiles. These are for Indian Navy, and now India, or you can say Defense Acquisition Council headed by the Defense Minister, approved the purchase. Reliance Retail became the first organized retail in the country to accept payments through UPI by scanning QR codes. And please don't forget, by scanning the QR code, please look into this picture. The existing system is through point of sale terminals, just swiping the card, and Reliance Retail became the first to accept payments with the scanning of quick response code. Please look into this picture. This is example of a quick response code. Name the state which will introduce Kisan Rahat bonds to raise money for the loan waiver scheme. I have already told you the state is Uttar Pradesh, and there are also demands coming from Maharashtra as well as Tamil Nadu for loan waiver. Look into the next one. Beneficiaries under Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana. You may have a doubt. What are the features of Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana? Please look into this slide. It is the subsidized program entirely sponsored by the central government. For each gas connection, the below poverty line families will be given rupees 1600 as a subsidy. And within 3 years, it is expected to cover 5 crore households. Please don't forget, India has 24 crore households. Out of 24 crore, 10 crore households are deprived of LPG around, but this figure got reduced substantially after the implementation of Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana, and now it may be around 7 to 8 crores households. Initially, at the starting of this program, 10 crore households are deprived of LPG. That's why government planned to give 1600 rupees per each LPG connection to BPL households, right? So out of 5 crore households expected to be covered by March 2019, already 2 crore families were covered by April 2017. And please don't forget, the program was launched in May 2016. Look into the next one. Virat Kohli was honored as the WISDEN leading cricketer in the world for the year 2016. And please don't forget, he had already been declared as, or you can say, to feature on the cover of 2017 edition of WISDEN Cricketer's Almanac. Please look into this picture. So Virat Kohli, WISDEN Cricketer's Almanac cover, that is one part. The second part is, he was honored as WISDEN leading cricketer in the world for the year 2016. Third important part is, he also won the prestigious Pauli Umrigar Award presented to the International Cricketer of the Year at the BCCI Annual Awards, right? So, three important awards to Virat Kohli. Japan officially recognized Bitcoin and all digital currencies as legal money along the lines of other fiat currencies. You may have two doubts. One is, what is fiat currency? Fiat currency is legal tender given by the authority. Fiat currency is nothing but the currency for which legal tender was declared by the competent authority, and it is legally valid for all the purposes, but it is not supported by any physical asset. So, market value determines its value. It is a legal tender, no doubt, but it will not be backed by any physical entity like gold. So, Indian currency, rupees 2000, rupees 500, these notes are all examples of fiat currency. Then the question comes, what is Bitcoin? Bitcoin is a type of digital currency or virtual currency created and held electronically. Here, two, three important points. No central banks or no government regulates them. Second important point is, they are not printed like dollars or euros or rupees. They are produced by the people, and increasingly businesses running computers all around the world using software that solves mathematical problems. It is also called cryptocurrency, and it is distributed peer-to-peer digital currency. Two, three important points is, it is not printed. Second point is, it is not governed by the central banks of the country. Third point is, no government intervenes, or you can say government can regulate, but government has got no role in it, or you can say the central bank or the government does not mint these types of bitcoins. It is basically produced by the people and distributed peer-to-peer way, right? So this is about Bitcoin. And now Japan officially recognized Bitcoin and digital currencies as legal money. Look into the next issue. The Reserve Bank of India cleared a proposal to introduce bank notes of rupees 200 denominations. The printing of rupees 200 notes is expected to commence shortly. India and the United Kingdom, they decided to set up £240 million green growth equity fund. Wherever you are talking about green growth equity fund, when someone is talking about green, the funding is normally for clean energy projects. So here, £240 million green growth equity fund to finance clean energy projects in India. So India and UK will share £120 million each. And another important aspect is, this is sub fund of National Investment and Infrastructure Fund, right? So India has already set up National Investment and Infrastructure Fund, and this is sub fund of this NIIF. Then Professor David Seemley took over as the chairman of UPSC, and he was awarded a Fulbright Senior Fellowship in 1999. Look into the next one. B.P. Kanungo took over as the Deputy Governor of Reserve Bank of India. Here, 2-3 important points I would like to tell you. Reserve Bank can have a maximum of 4 Deputy Governors, and Kanungo was appointed for a period of 3 years. Third point is, he replaced Gandhi. NIRF, for the second time, released the best educational institutions rankings. And what is meant by NIRF? NIRF is National Institutional Ranking Framework, under which ministry it functions. It is under the Ministry of Human Resource Development. And you may have a doubt, what are the parameters? There are 5 parameters. Please go through them. For releasing the rankings, the institutions are ranked based on 5 parameters. The 5 parameters I have given here. So based on these 5 parameters, institutions are ranked. And one is overall. Overall is IISc Bengaluru, followed by IIT Madras and IIT Bombay. And if you look at engineering, IIT Madras. If you look at management, IIM Ahmedabad. Then if you look at universities, IISc Bengaluru, and if you look at colleges, Miranda House in Delhi, and if you look at pharmacy, it is Jamia Hamdard in New Delhi. So total, there are 6 categories. One is overall category. In addition to overall category, there are 5 categories, and institutions are ranked based on 5 parameters. These things are very important. World Autism Awareness Day. You may have a doubt, what is meant by autism? Autism is basically neurodevelopmental disorder. Neurodevelopmental disorder. And what are the traits of autism? Traits of autism are difficulty in communication, then difficulty in social interactions, obsessive interests, and repetitive behaviors. These are the traits of autism, and World Autism Awareness Day is observed every year on 2nd April across the world to raise awareness about the autism, right? So the theme this year is towards autonomy and self-determination. And don't forget, autism is now a category under the Disabilities Act, which came into force recently, where the total number of categories increased from 7 to 21. These things please don't forget. Look into the next one. Myanmar became the 7th member of South Asia Sub-Regional Economic Cooperation, or SESEC. SESEC has got 7 countries. You may have a doubt, for what purpose this is established? Basically, it is a project-based partnership to promote regional prosperity. The main purpose is to promote cross-border connectivity, boosting trade among the member countries, and strengthening regional economic cooperation. So, at the behest of Asian Development Bank or ADB, or you can say ADB houses the secretariat and the lead financier of SESEC program, and so far ADB supported 46 projects, and here there are 7 countries. The 7th country is Myanmar now, and in addition to Myanmar, Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, Maldives, Nepal, Sri Lanka and Myanmar. So these 7 countries basically established as a project-based partnership, basically to promote regional prosperity by improving cross-border connectivity. That is the purpose of SESEC. It is the brainchild of Asian Development Bank. Then NTPC achieved the milestone of 50,000 megawatt power generation capacity. NTPC was established in 1975. And please don't forget, we crossed several milestones. One of the milestone which we crossed last year, our power generation capacity crossed 300 gigawatt. Please note down, power generation capacity crossed 300 gigawatt. And one of the main power producers in the public sector, NTPC, achieved the generation capacity of 50 gigawatt. So, out of the total power generation potential of around 300 gigawatt plus, you can say roughly 300 gigawatt, out of 300 gigawatt, the potential of NTPC itself is 50 gigawatt. And please don't forget other milestones during the year 2016-17, the solar power generation capacity crossed 10 gigawatt. Solar power generation capacity crossed 10 gigawatt. At the same time, wind power generation capacity crossed 30 gigawatt. And overall, renewable energy generation capacity crossed 50 gigawatt. So, these milestones are very, very important because government is giving more thrust for renewable energy. And 64th National Film Awards were announced. Kasav, the best feature film award, has gone to Marathi film. And in the non-feature film category, Fireflies in the Abyss. And most popular film providing wholesome entertainment has gone to Satamanam Bhavati. And the other things I have given here, best director is Rajesh Mapuskar for Ventilator, best actor Akshay Kumar for Rustum, best actress Surabhi Lakshmi. So these are salient features of 64th National Film Awards. Best children's film is Dhanak, best film on social issue is Pink. Right friends, we came to the end of facts and figures. Please do join for Why and How. Have a nice day. Thank you.